finish this. Be gone. Finish this! Finish this! Finish this!
What's wrong? Why are you holding back?
I'm ready to get serious, but I don't want to injure the VIP.
What? Who's he talking about?
Where'd you get that idea?
What the? Why is the ground shaking? That's space battleship Gargantua!
We will now begin a full-scale attack with over 2 million battleships. But before that... Your father awaits you, Jennifer. Come with me.
Father? I thought her parents passed away when she was a child.
What? You didn't know? She is General Carter's foster child.
What?
I'm sorry, Gordon. What Curtis said is true. I was adopted by General Carter and raised as his child. He was a kind man. I always believed that he loved me. But that couldn't have been further from the truth. He raised me only so he could use me.
If you're going to complain about your father, tell him yourself. My orders are simply to bring you back alive.
He wants to use me again? It doesn't matter anymore.
Wait! Jennifer, don't go! You're the assistant of Captain Gordon, Defender of Earth, remember? Have you forgotten our sworn duty?
Didn't you dismiss her?
Shut up! Don't dig up the past! I retracted that! Jennifer, it doesn't matter if you're Carter's daughter or not. As the assistant to the Defender of Earth, listen to your heart! What is right? What do you believe in? And what will you do right now?
Gordon.
Enough talk. Gordon, Overlord. I'd like to settle this once and for all. If you want Jennifer back, then find a way aboard the Gargantua. Until then, see ya.
Jennifer! Jennifer!
To be continued.
This is a bit worrisome. I never thought human intervention could cause such disorder.
Nor did I.
This may hinder our plans.
Yes, indeed.
What is troubling you? Is there something else?
I cannot believe that this is the work of humans alone. Someone must be pulling the strings. Do you have an idea who it might be?
I think so, but I cannot be certain.
I see. I will investigate the matter.
But if you strain yourself much more, you will...
That is of little concern. Compared to the ordeal they are enduring,
Episode 13, War of the Netherworld, Part 2.
Damn it! Pesky humans!
What do they want with the Netherworld, I wonder?
Beats me. I don't understand how humans think.
I'm back!
How'd it go, Gordon?
Easy, as expected. Using Thursday's navigation system, I was able to lock onto the gargantua's coordinates.
Good work. Now we can board the ship directly.
But still, I'm surprised you were able to find the coordinates. You look about as smart as a rock.
Well, it seems that Jennifer had already programmed them in.
Jennifer did? Then did she expect this to happen?
I guess so. But she must have wanted to give her father the benefit of the doubt. That's probably why she never told me about it.
Hey, how long are you planning on sitting around? We can't just let the humans have their way. Let's go! I shall show those fools what happens when you pick a fight with an Overlord!
Yeah! We'll show them!
That's right! I'm overwhelmed with hero spirit! I'll save Jennifer no matter what!
This is getting interesting. Prince, I'm going to the bathroom, okay?
Wait.
Here I come! Foolish, weak humans! Feel the wrath of the Overlord!
General Carter! Demons have commenced an attack!
Don't fret for even a moment. Our armada is 2 million ships strong. What are the enemy's numbers?
Just one, sir!
The 126th Brigade has been annihilated. All soldiers have retreated. The Admiral Impet is taking ground! Admiral Jackson and his crew have abandoned ship!
The 782nd Brigade is out of commission! The 15th and 981st Brigades have requested emergency assistance!
Oh, this is a nightmare! Armada's being wiped out by a single demon? Impossible! I've I've heard nothing of this kind of strength.
Looks like I took care of most of them. What a weak bunch.
You really pay attention to the details, giving them time to escape before destroying their ships.
See? He's not devoid of love.
Shut up! I just don't want to stink up the Netherworld with human corpses. I'm not...
Beep, beep, blip, beep. High energy reading emanating from cannon.
Everybody, look out!
What was that?
Is that their secret weapon?
You imbecile! Now's not the time to be impressed! That's the Astro Cannon, the ETF's ultimate weapon! Demon or angel, you won't escape a shot unscathed.
Interesting.
Didn't you hear what Mr. Gordon said? Let's just avoid the cannon for now.
What? That's no fun.
Listen up, everyone. We have to find the entrance so we can sneak aboard. Hang in there, Jennifer. I'll save you. No matter what lies ahead, Captain Gordon, Defender of Earth, will fight to the end.
You're wrong, Papa. You must stop. Please, Papa, listen to me.
Where am I?
Are you awake?
Curtis.
Were you having a nightmare? You were tossing and turning. It doesn't matter. You won't have to worry about having those dreams anymore.
Curtis, that thing in your hand.
You guessed it. Very good, Professor. You must know what it does then.
Stop it, Curtis. You call yourself human?
Do I? I lost 70% of my body and something even more dear to me in an incident. Maybe I lost my sense of humanity at that time, too. It's time to sleep. Sweet dreams.
That scream!
It's Miss Jennifer!
It's coming from that way!
Let's go!
More humans!
Oh,
they just don't learn, do they?
Beep, beep, blip, beep, they are not human. Life signs 0.00000.
Everyone, be careful. These are superhuman androids constructed by Curtis.
Super
human
androids?
That's right. Curtis is a brilliant scientist, rivaling even Jennifer. But he's been conducting fearful research, all in the name of humanity. Could that scream be... No! He's attempting to modify Jennifer!
He's attempting... to modify?
Jennifer?
Hey! Stop imagining weird things! We have to save Jennifer!
Die. Go!
This. Be gone! finish this!
Beep, beep, blip, beep. Captain Gordon, incoming message from General Carter.
From Carter? Okay, Thursday. Open a communication channel. Carter!
You're being a sore loser, Gordon.
Of course! I can't let a villain like you win for the sake of Earth! I swear by the name Defender of Earth, Carter, I will defeat you!
You just don't get it, do you? This invasion is for the sake of Earth.
What?
As you know, the Earth is confronting a serious crisis. The boom in population, the rise in crime, and the shortage of natural resources. The human race can't survive much longer. It would require an astronomical budget merely to find a new home for the people of Earth. That's why taking over the Netherworld is such a simple and economical solution.
Your efforts are admirable. You'd make a great demon.
But there wouldn't be a crisis in the first place if you humans weren't so stupid. As the Overlord of the Netherworld, let me say just one thing. Clean up your own damn mess!
You foul-mouthed little runt!
I have something to add to that. General Carter, I am beyond angry! Give back my Jennifer, Chrome Dome!
Why, you? You can't play nice. Neither will I. I'll crush you for the sake of Earth's future. Prepare yourselves.
Thank you.
drop dead. Punk!
Paul!
I'll finish this! Be gone!
Thank you.
this.
Curtis!
Glad you could make it, Gordon. I knew the hordes of security guards wouldn't be enough to stop you. I thought you might like to know. It's been 5 years since I lost my wife and daughter, and with them, my soul.
Hey, he's giving us his life story.
Should we attack now?
No, we have to listen! The rival always has a tragic past.
May I continue?
Oh, please, by all means.
As I was saying, it's been 5 years since I lost my wife and daughter, and with them, my soul. Back then, I was a top scientist, burning with a passion to save the Earth. If it wasn't for that fateful incident,
5 years ago?
As a result of the explosion in the lab, I lost my family and 70% of my body.
A group of anti-space development terrorists were to blame.
You mean your wife and daughter were victims of that incident?
That's right. You caught the culprits, but what comfort would that be to me? I swore to my wife and child, since the Defender of Earth couldn't do his job, I would take his place. And I became a cyborg to do just that. What good is the Defender of Earth if he can't save innocent people? A true defender would do anything in his power to save as many people as possible. I can't accept anything less. I will defeat you, Gordon, and claim the title of true Defender of Earth. That is the only path left to me.
So that's it. I didn't know you had such a past, Curtis. It was all due to my failings. Forgive me. But what you're doing now, Curtis, is not the right way.
What? I'm fighting for the sake of humanity.
Invading the Netherworld might save the Earth, but it would require many sacrifices. Is that what you want? Is that really for the sake of Earth? You should know best what it feels like to be a victim, Curtis. What will your wife and daughter think up in heaven? I am the Defender of Earth. My duty is to right what is wrong, even if it means that I must face a comrade in arms. I don't want to fight you, but this is for your own good. Here I come, comrade. Behold, the true spirit of a defender!
finish this! Be gone!
Die!
Finish this! Be gone!
Eat this!
Here I come! this.
You're dead.
Well done. You've proven me wrong. I felt the true defender's spirit, the strength of your determination, even in this mechanical body. I lost. Now, finish me.
Okay. We'll kill you in one painless blow.
You can't!
Curtis, our battle has already ended. You tried to do what you thought was right. It's just that your sorrow drove you to do it in the wrong way. That's why I want you to fight by my side, as a comrade. How about it?
Gordon.
I could use a skilled person like you as one of my vassals.
The Overlord's vassal. That doesn't sound too bad. But it seems that my body needs to recharge. I must sleep for a while. Gordon, be careful of Jennifer.
Curtis! Be careful of Jennifer? What does he mean by that?
Be careful of
Jennifer?
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Modification?
Mm-hmm. Modification.
Will you three grow up already? We finally got you cornered, Carter! Release Jennifer now!
As you wish.
Jennifer!
Hey!
Uh-huh.
That's not what I expected.
Me neither.
Hey, you call this a modification?
So you found out about it, eh? That's right. I've installed a neural override device. Jennifer is now my puppet. Jennifer, go defeat Gordon!
This must be a joke! I, the defender of Earth, could never lose to such a delicate creature!
Jeez, you
you're weak.
Gordon, maybe you're not cut out to be a hero.
What do you think of that? Jennifer is a master of the ancient martial art, Kung Fu.
What? I never knew that.
You never asked.
That explains it. So what am I supposed to do? No way can I use my full fighting potential against Jennifer.
You'd lose anyways, man.
How about we just blow up the entire ship?
Oh, no, you don't. I already claimed this ship.
I see. Well, so much for that idea.
Captain Gordon, Defender of Earth, facing his greatest challenge ever!
How pathetic, Gordon. What happened to that spirit you were bragging about?
Curtis, you're better already.
Your voice woke my heart up to the ideals I forgot long ago. Stand aside. Let me show you my defender spirit.
Jennifer, kill that traitor first.
Gordon, you called me a comrade. I looked up to you. That's why I became a scientist in the first place. Funny, isn't it? How did things end up like this? If only I had realized sooner. No, it's enough that I realized it in the end. I bet they're smiling down on me from heaven.
Jennifer, stop wasting your time with that miserable traitor. Curse you all! I'll just blow you all up, and Jennifer too. In case of an event like this, I planted a bomb inside the neural override device. Now die!
I made that device, and I know its weakness. Jennifer, I can't let you die here!
Curtis!
Hey, Gordon, do you think I could ever be a true defender of Earth?
Yeah, of course you could be! What am I saying? You are a true defender of Earth!
Thanks, Gordon. I won't forget the defender spirit you showed me.
I should be the one thanking you, Curtis. You will be known as the 38th Defender of Earth.
Heed my words, Death. I command you in the name of King Laharl. Lead the soul of Curtis, Defender of Earth, to his family's side.
Prince.
Laharl.
Don't say a word. As the Overlord of the Netherworld, I was just paying homage to a true hero. That's all.
Yes, I understand.
Carter, I'll never forgive you.
Wait, Gordon!
Jennifer, you're back to normal!
Yes, I was conscious the entire time I was being controlled. Because of me, Curtis...
He did what he thought was right. I'm sure he has no regrets. And now his spirit will burn brightly in your heart.
Yeah, you're right.
Jennifer, you are no longer my assistant. Fight alongside me as an equal, as a defender of Earth.
Thank you, Gordon. I understand. Let's forget about the past and concentrate on the present.
Wait, wait! Jennifer! I'm your father! Have you forgotten everything that I've done for you?
No, I haven't. If you hadn't taken me in back then, I might not be here today. I loved you and believed in you. But we were never a true family to begin with. You raised me only so you could manipulate me. I'll never call you father again. Prepare yourself, Carter.
You ungrateful little... That's it. Die!
A celestial host? Why? Why are angels helping him?
Apparently, someone's been pulling strings from behind the scenes.
Celestia's involved, huh? It just keeps getting better, Prince.
It can't be. Is this the will of the Seraph?
Repent. Pray. Fool.
Thank you.
Here I come!
Finish this! Be gone!
Die. Pray. Fools. Fools.
Finish this!
Fools. Die. You're dead.
This time, but I'm not through yet. Wait, Carter! Farewell! I can't believe it! Demons are that powerful! His information was completely wrong. Damn him! Is he trying to drive humanity into extinction from the beginning?
Who is he?
Oh, who are you?
No matter how advanced your technology is, it is impossible to infiltrate the Netherworld without help. Now answer, who is behind this?
I can't.
If you do not say, I will kill you.
It's a man with white wings. I'm innocent. I just wanted to save the Earth.
I see. Foolish human. You cannot save the Earth. How do you intend to save all of mankind when you cannot even save your daughter? You have sacrificed the lives of others to satisfy your own ego. Until you realize that, you will be plagued by nightmares. We will be watching you.
Oh, why am I so awesome?
Thank you, Curtis. I will never forget you. I swear to you that I will fight with both our strength for the sake of humanity. No, not just for humanity, for every living creature.
I will too, Curtis. You saved my life. I shall repay you by dedicating it to world peace and to preventing others from becoming victims like you and your family.
Juan?
I'm going back to Celestia.
What?
I must return to find out the Seraph's true intentions.
Like one problem leads to another. We find out that the humans were being manipulated by the angels. Now, Flan wants to return to Celestia to go face to face with the Seraph himself. What awaits her there? Will the Archangel's true intent be finally revealed? Next on Disgaea, Hour of Darkness, final episode, What Lies Beyond the Battle? The fate of the Netherworld is in your hands.
This must be a dream.
He's acting all serious.
Could this be a sign of terrible things to come?
It's the end of the world!
End of the world? Danger, danger, danger.
Dude! Everybody run!
They're gonna get it.
After learning that Celestia was behind the incident with the Earth Defense Force, I made up my mind to go back to Celestia to ask the Seraph about it directly. The Netherworld. Celestia. The human world. I never imagined that this war, which involved the entire universe, would come to such an unexpected end.
Your mind's made up?
Yes. I must speak with the Seraph and find out what has been happening in Celestia.
Do you realize that you may have to face him as an enemy?
Face Master Lamington as my enemy?
He's the head of Celestia, right? We know that someone in Celestia has been helping the EDF. He must have known about it.
I agree. I think it's very possible that he's even the mastermind.
Wasn't he the one who ordered you to go to the Netherworld in the first place? To assassinate my old man?
What? An angel ordering an assassination? That's just wrong! He's guilty without a doubt!
No, he's not!
Can you say that for sure?
I believe in Master Lamington!
I see. All right then, let's get going. It's a good opportunity for me to check out this so-called Seraph. I'm going with you.
Laharl!
Jeez, Prince, why don't you just admit it?
I'm worried about Flan, so I'm gonna go with her.
What's so hard about that, huh?
Fool! That's far from the truth!
Now, now. We all feel the same way, Harley.
Jennifer's right. As the defender of Earth, I cannot let my comrade go alone.
Beep, beep, bleep, beep. We are comrades. We go together. End of discussion.
Bunch of fools.
Thank you.
final episode, What Lies Beyond the Battle. Is the entrance to Celestia.
It is said that one of the former Seraphs had this gate constructed to cut off the Netherworld from Celestia. That's why it can only be opened by the residents of Celestia.
That's not fair.
Okay, I'm going to open the gate. Is everybody ready?
Bonjour, everyone. It is a pleasure to see you here.
Oh, it's you, Mr. Midboss.
Weren't you saying earlier that only Celestians can open this gate?
Oh, that's strange.
It has been thousands of years since a demon other than moi passed through this gate.
It's all clear to me now. You're an evil henchman who's been hired by the Seraph.
Wrong!
I know! You're an angel in disguise!
Another wrong answer!
You all have very active imaginations, but I, the Dark Adonis, just happened to be passing by. Nothing more.
So, Dark Adonis, why is it that you're in Celestia?
I am here to test your resolve.
What?
From this point on, you will face challenges unlike anything you have experienced before. Whether or not you can emerge victorious, I would like to see with my own eyes.
But what does that have to do with you? Why do you care? Answer me!
We have talked long enough. Show me what you are capable of.
Finish this! Be gone!